you can look at this eclipse as any universal movement, as wonderful as your science is. It hasn't touched on what is available for your understanding, especially about things like this that happened in your consciousness. But there is so much more. So we say that this is light coming in. This is opportunity for change.
I'd like to welcome back to the show, returning champion, Cindy Edison. How are you doing, Cindy?
I'm good. How are you, Alex?
I'm good. Thank you so much for coming back on the show. Last time we spoke, the audience really loved having you and Josef.
Wow, they're great. They get it. Your audience gets it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, last time you were on, a couple things happened in your life after the episode aired, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Blew up.
It went a little... Everything blew up?
It really blew up. And I'll tell you, the most exciting part for me was reading the comments and how your audience, you know, we are teachers of teachers with all this new stuff, the way we teach it. And in the beginning, people weren't getting it. You know, they just weren't getting it, couldn't grasp it. But your audience gets it. They're doing it. You know, I mean, I see these people. Awesome. I'm so glad that she said that, because that's how I channel too, or that's what I went through too, or, you know, didn't want to say anything, that's, you know, great. So yay. Bravo. Yeah,
my audience is pretty amazing. Yeah. I see my audience is pretty amazing. And I keep hearing it again and again from my guests about when they interact with my audience. They're like, it's not like any other audience they've ever interacted with before. No. So it makes me happy. It really makes me happy that
beautiful.
Way. So, I wanted to bring you back on the show because it's been a while since last time you were on the show. So there's a few things have changed in the world since last time we spoke. So first I wanted it because there's a lot of fear in the world as a general statement. But there seems to be a ramping up of fear around what's going to happen. Where are we going? What do you see from Joseph's side? And but hold on, before we continue, we have to tell everybody, because you and I both know what you do. Can you explain to people who might not have seen the first episode what you do? And when we speak of Josef, who Josef is?
Yeah, Josef is a collective consciousness of teachers, and they are the evolved conscious vibration of the Seth and Abraham collectives. So, you know, as a consciousness, as more focus on the message, in this case, of Seth and then Abraham, you can see how the audiences have just grown exponentially. They're just, you know, so obviously the consciousness is expanding within the human collective awareness. And as that happens, you know, our wanting more comes in. And so this is part of our evolution as the human aspect. So they are teaching from this consciousness, and we focus on the journey to the new earth. And the, you know, we kind of talk about a little bit about our journey through the third dimension and how we're kind of walking out of it. You know, we say we're choosing our way out of it as we move into the next dimension of experience. So our whole shtick is that, you know, we are all about, and we example, I always laugh when they say it. We example the blending of the vibration of the soul and the physical aspect. So it's a channeling, in that when I am speaking to you or to clients or anybody, I am focused solely on the soul vibration of me, which makes them dominant, makes the collective me dominant, my soul and all its aspects, of which I am one. So this is our next step in human evolution, where we are actually, up to this point, the human, ever since we dove into the third dimension, the first time we ever got here in order to expand the universe, you know, expand the soul by focusing on love, we come in, we don't know who we are. We have no idea, which is the point. So we can discover more of who we are as we journey through the third dimension, we call it that. Mm-hmm. Everybody, we got to label everything, right? So mm-hmm. we dive in, and through lifetime after lifetime, we leave, we come back, we leave, we come back. And every time we come back, we have expanded this aspect, the physical aspect of the soul, more so. So here we are now at 50-50, dominant in the contrast. Obviously, you can look outside and see, which is why everybody's in such fear now. You know, the more you look at it, the more it expands in your awareness, and you participate, and then you live a life of fear. We are moving out of that, and this must be a conscious choosing. Up to this point, we didn't understand the choosing of experiences by looking at everything from a vibrational perspective, you know, universal law stuff, universal truth, we call it. So now, up to this point, we have been dominantly creating not only our unique individual physical experience from the contrast. That's why relationships don't, you know, it's a failing relationship. That's how all relationships are. We have all these sayings, you know, it's how all relationships are. They're just hard. This is hard. This is hard. And it's just not that way. But that's what our dominant creative force is. So then we come in and we say, well, in order to move out of the contrast, you must shift your perspective, which means shifting your perspective to the perspective of the next consciousness, realm of consciousness that we're moving into, which has a different experience, offers a different experience. And when you become dominant, when you consciously choose to shift your dominant creative force from the mm-hmm. contrast to that of your soul, then you're at 51%. And then you're attracting, law of attraction, you're attracting from that vibration, which is love and peace and joy. And the more you focus on that, you gain momentum, and that becomes your dominant creative force, and you're creating from. So all that to say that Josef is the soul of me, and when I am focused on them, I'm in alignment. And so it is the collective that's speaking. The soul is speaking.
So, and when you say that you're connecting to Josef in this collective, you are channeling. Just so everyone's clear, I want to make sure.
Yeah, we'll have a new name for that, though, because it's got a lot of stigma, you know. Because mm-hmm. channeling, exactly. If it doesn't look the same way on everybody, you know, they go, well, I must not be doing it. And you see people coming out of the woodwork saying, that's how I do it too. I hear things too. I thought I was weird. You're not. Mm-hmm. Everybody's doing it.
So when you're doing your process of talking to or communicating with this collective, you're not a trans channel. You are actually just asking the question, and it's just coming in on you 24/7, essentially.
Well, yeah, yes, they... 4 or 5 months ago, they started saying, we want to be more involved in your day-to-day focus. When you're living in your third dimensional life, this is how we get to the fourth dimension, by the way, which is why they're teaching me. We want to be involved, you know, focus on us when you have to make a decision, you know, get an alignment and make a decision. That way you create these pathways to the experiences that we have here. It's how you create your reality. You know, you're creating experiences all the time. And the experiences come from the foundational vibration that you're focused on, that you're dominant in at the time. So when you're dominantly creating from your soul vibration, you can only experience what that vibration offers, which is love and peace and joy and excitement and passion and all that good stuff. It cannot manifest an out of alignment experience. Can't create fear from love, nor Correct. Can you create love from fear. Two different vibrations, no agreement.
You know, when you say vibration, or another word, frequency, if they're being the same thing, that's why low vibration or low frequency cannot coexist with a high frequency. They just don't. It's physics. They literally won't be able to deal with it. I always joke, it's like that's why you don't see a lot of yogis getting mugged.
I love when there's you not say a lot. That. Yeah, I love when you say that. It's absolutely right. No vibrational agreement. You cannot experience a vibration that you're not a match to.
Exactly, and that's their goal, is to raise your frequency as much as you possibly can to reach the frequency of the ascended masters, to go to a higher place where you're almost beyond, at such a high level that some of these yogis and some of these masters, when you walked in the room, or if you walked within 100 feet of them, you were completely intoxicated by their vibration or their frequency. Yeah.
Yes.
It's a pretty magical thing, but we're all going to, and we're all capable of it. And that's what Jesus
doing
said.
It
and that's
all
what,
the time. Yeah. Doing it all the time. Yeah.
Yeah. We're all capable of reaching the heights of these masters. It's just our choice on how we get there.
Yeah. And they're called master because they mastered the dimension, right?
Correct.
Joseph says, when you can be, you see, we take these steps. So far the human, I'll make this really quick. So far the human aspect, the physical aspect, has been creating ever since it got here, dominantly from its contrasting side, which is why we have chaos and war and famine and abuse. And, you know, those are out of alignment manifestations from creating from the contrast. Mm-hmm. When you shift, so when you get to the 5149, now you're dominantly creating from love. We call it the downhill on the roller coaster. You know, it's all downhill from there, because once you experience it, you know, on a consistent level, why would you ever choose anything else?
Right. You know? Exactly. Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Now, with everything that's happening in the world today, do you see any, or does Joseph see any significant changes happening for humanity in this year?
There are significant changes happening daily now, and there are pockets of information that are coming through, and depending on what you're focused on is the experience you will have. This is the, what's happening in the earth plane is the choosing, the experience that the human collective is creating dominantly from the contrast, if you choose to focus there, is what is stirring everything up. But the shift in consciousness that is a natural progression, you have shifted consciousnesses many, many, many unlimited times in your experience as an aspect. So you have to keep in mind that the more contrast that is being exposed, we've heard it, we've said it actually, that in your third dimensional world, we would call it a now evolved war, a cyber war, which is the space you have taken yourselves to. Mm-hmm. Most of it very, very good, and some not so good in your language. We see it as the contrast, and we see that the human collective is creating more and more. However, there is always balance. So as the shift is happening, this is why we say that this next step for humanity is a conscious choosing. It must be a conscious choosing. You're stepping into a realm that offers a different physical experience. Now, when we say that, you must understand too that our message is based on universal truth. And as you know, and as we've been talking, that it is a vibrational foundation where everything is created and manifested through vibrational agreement. You must keep that in mind when you are talking about and thinking about and participating in and acting upon your goings on in your world.
When you're talking right now, you're talking a lot of we's. So Joseph is talking through you at the moment. This is not you talking, correct? Yeah.
Well, it's okay. It's all of us. Me being the mouthpiece.
Right. Exactly. It's a collective.
They're holding me back. You know, I wanted to be a little more, you know, sassy. And they hold me. Yes. They usually let me get away with it, but they're funny. They're funny. Okay, let us just say this to you, that we will give you the pathway out of this this puzzle that you are creating. Some people say, what does it look like from your point of view? And I say, from the eyes of Joseph, it looks like a traffic jam. It just looks like a big traffic jam. That's what I feel. That's what I feel when I see that. Can't describe it any other way. It feels like a big traffic jam. The only way out is to choose love. The only way out is to choose a different vibration from which to create. And that starts on an individual level. But as Abraham, you know, has been teaching for many, many years, seriously, one in alignment is more powerful than a million who aren't, because that one in alignment is creating from the space of love, the space of the soul, the God consciousness, the Christ consciousness. There's nothing more powerful than that. So the only way that you move from this space, and you certainly don't have to, you're not going anywhere. You certainly don't have to. It's a choosing. But you must choose to focus on love more than fear. That's how you get into alignment, first of all. But you must choose it in every moment, and soon you will be a collective that lives it.
Now, as of this recording, the April 8th eclipse is coming down the time. What is the global impact to the global spiritual energy, the impact to global spiritual energy that eclipse is going to do? What is it? Because a lot of people are afraid of it, of course, because, you know, obviously the aliens are coming, you know, and the comet's coming to destroy us, obviously. Any day now, the dinosaurs will be back. But
use them as pets. What,
yes, exactly. So what effect is this going to have on the collective as far as our consciousness is concerned and just spiritual energy on the planet in general?
We're going to say it again. It's, we liken this to, because we've gotten this question, but we liken this to the generality and collective belief in Mercury retrograde, where people say, get under the covers and hide. And so this is, you know, we kind of chuckle at that, but this eclipse is no different than any other eclipse. Some you've experienced, some you have no idea of, but it is part of the shift. It is part of the universal movement, and it offers a new experience. It offers a choice. It offers a choice. There is not darkness being poured into your realm of consciousness. There is what you refer to as darkness, but we see as contrast. It is a choosing space. And if you see it as such, then you will understand to choose your way out. So you can look at this eclipse as any universal movement, and all how as wonderful as your science is, it hasn't touched on what is available for your understanding, especially about things like this that happened in your consciousness. But there is so much more. So we say that this is light coming in. This is opportunity for change. This is opportunity for, I don't know about you, Alex, but I am just buzzing right now. Can you feel that? Mm-hmm, wow. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That's so cool. Sorry. So we would tell you to move into this space, not unlike any advice we would ever give, move into the space of light that is available, that is pouring in. Picture it like a pitcher. A pitcher is just coming. You can step in the middle of it. You will experience, as you do any universal shift, you will experience this eclipse as either an in or out of alignment opportunity. And if you choose the in alignment position, you will expand your aspect, which is the point of you being here. You will be consciously choosing to expand this physical aspect that is you. Or you can jump in your bed and pull the covers over your head and wait for it to pass and increase, expand the fear quotient by choosing it.
Will the eclipse influence individuals' challenges or personal growths as they're going through life?
It's the same answer.
Yeah.
It's the same answer. It's always the same answer because it's a vibrational movement. Your universe moves by vibration. You cannot have a manifestation without vibrational agreement. So if you go into this believing that you will, something's going to happen, some big explode, whatever it is, some big catastrophe is going to happen somewhere, either in your personal life or globally, country, whatever. You will experience the fear of that, which means that you are choosing and creating a pathway toward an experience when you focus on it. So if somebody says to you, Alex, this thing is going to be really bad. It's going to be really bad. You know, they're predicting all these outages and people are going to go crazy and all this stuff. Same thing happened in, remember when we flipped over Y2K. The year 2000?
Yeah. Y2K, 2012.
The whole place was imploding. Yeah,
1984. Right. It's constant.
Yeah. Fear, right? Yeah. Only manifestations of fear. So it doesn't matter what's going on where you as an individual, unique physical aspect of your unique soul, doesn't matter what's going on around you. You get to choose your experience of it. And if you have the perspective of your soul, which is the shifting of your dominant creative vibration, mm-hmm. right, into alignment, if you're focused on that, if you're focused on only alignment, on focusing on being in alignment, and you're still in the third dimension, so you're not going to be in alignment all the time. It's what tethers you to this realm of consciousness. But the more you focus on that, that's your eternal soul's pathway. And all your stuff is there, you know, the experiences that you want to have to expand, you know, their event, your eternal path is event driven, all about understanding who you are and then living it, you know, those aha moments.
So many of us are going through, you know, adverse times in our own mm-hmm. lives because of the things you're talking about. About yeah. focusing on the fear, about focusing on the negative, if you will. What lessons can people learn about through these adversities? Because I don't know about you, I've learned the most out of the negative things that have happened in my life. Whether I liked it or not, as it was happening to me, is irrelevant. Looking back on it, you're like, thank God that happened. So what lessons can people learn from these adversity or dealing with this kind of stuff on a daily basis?
Yeah. And it seems to be, if you look at it from that perspective, it's getting worse every day. You know, it's mm-hmm. always something. Every time you turn around, it's something else. And I get this question a lot. It's a vibrational shift. I don't know how else to say it. And I know it sounds so repetitive, but when you can shift your perspective about what fear is mm-hmm. and how it creates and what it creates and how to recognize that you are creating from it. We prefer the contrast. Once you understand it from a vibrational perspective, from the perspective of your soul, it removes the fear, it removes the judgment. So when you have a thought, about something, so pick something, politics. I don't want to talk about mm-hmm. politics. I just want to pick it. It's mm-hmm. crazy, right? It's crazy mm-hmm. everywhere. It's crazy. And it's very divided. So depending on what side you're on, what you've chosen to focus on, if that focus evokes fear in you, what's going to happen? Are we going to be okay? Or, you know, oh my God, the price is going to go through the roof, whatever it is. You are creating a pathway in that contrast to experience that vibration that you're choosing to focus on. So that is the shift from calling things fear and love to in and out of alignment. The first indication that everyone has that we have vibrational communication again from the aspects of you is your emotional response. And if your first emotion about a situation, circumstance, whatever, news, whatever you see, is fear, is anger, is jealousy, is loneliness or sadness, heartache, all those that go with the contrast, right? Mm-hmm. The contrast is the vibrational agreement for that focus you have. So of course you're going to create an out of alignment experience from it. War, ultimately, collective grouping, you know? So if you feel an out of alignment emotion, which is out of alignment with who you really are, that is your first indication that you're dominantly creating from the contrasting side of you, the physical vibration of you, not the non-physical vibration of you, who is your soul. So it's at that point that you say, wait a minute, I don't have to choose this. I don't have to create a fearful experience for myself. I'm going to choose something else. I'm going to choose love. Now, that's kind of difficult. We're talking about politics, but you can. I have done it. You can do it. Absolutely. And that's when you begin to change.
Let me ask you, because a lot, I get this question all the time. Why do bad things happen to good people? We all, you know, when we see it in a movie or we see it in a TV show, it gets us upset. When we see it in our own lives, it really irks us. What role does karma have when these challenges are faced by good people? Because it seems like, oh, it's not fair that this happened to that person. She's never heard of a fly in her life kind of thing. Yeah. I'd love to hear Joseph's perspective on that.
Well, you know, our perspective of what karma is, of course, is very different from what is kind of generally believed in the contrast. And that is that, again, the physical vibration of you have been collecting through every single lifetime that you have experienced in the third dimension. Mm-hmm. When you kick off, the only thing you take with you is love, is the loving vibration that you have experienced here. However many times, it doesn't matter. You have expanded through love. And so when you die, you take that love with you. It's the only thing that's in vibrational agreement with your soul. It's the only thing that can go with you, right? And that physical vibration of you lies dormant on that vibrational timeline until your soul refocuses and we stand up and we say, okay, we're ready to go again. So then that's when the next level of expansion happens for the physical vibration. But you are evidence. I am evidence. Every human who's on the planet right now is evidence that their physical vibration is still dominant in the contrast. So that means that every experience you had, every understanding that you ever had coming up through the ranks, thousands of years here, evolving and learning new things, new teachings, new parents, new beliefs, new everything. As the human evolves, those things evolve, right? And you carry that in your physical vibrational makeup. So when that's what we say karma, that's how we describe what karma is. It's not a punishment because there is no judgment from our perspective. There's no punishing. There's never anything wrong. There's only vibrational agreement. That's all there ever is. So, you know, good people, there's no bad person. There's just in and out of alignment experiences. And so the fact that that good guy is here in the third dimension is evidence that he has an out of alignment vibration. Of course he does. He's here. He's in the contrast, which means part of his vibration is still in alignment with the contrast, or he wouldn't be here. You cannot be here and be in the fifth dimension at the same time. There's no contrast there.
That's why we come down here, is to experience contrast.
To expand. To expand. Experience and understand that you can choose. It's a choosing place.
So the way you're presenting karma, I understand completely what you're saying, is that it's not a punishment like so many people say. But from my understanding of karma, from my research and people I've spoken to on the show, is that it's correct. You're correct that there is not a punishment, but you choose when you come back into a life to work out that vibration that is stuck here, like you're saying, that is aligned with this physical vibration, to overcome it and to finally choose out of that vibration, but you have to kind of go through it through the contrast. Does that make sense?
Well, you know, some people say your it cracks me up. Some people say your soul plans out these bad experiences for you. Mm-hmm. That's impossible. That is impossible. Mm-hmm. Your soul cannot create an out of alignment experience, nor would it. It's pure mm-hmm. love, which is why we come equipped with our ego aspect, who is also pure love. The ego is the balance, the universal balance to the soul in the third dimension. The soul provides us communication, vibrational communication that results in those first indications. Remember, we talked about emotions. When you see something and it evokes in you an immediate love, joy, authentic, you know, just beautiful excitement, that's your soul communicating with you. Yes, 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 that's alignment. But when we are the choosers. When we choose to focus on, you know, an out of alignment situation and get all mad and pissed off and stuff, our ego steps in and says, okay, if you're going to continue to focus there, Cindy, unique human aspect, free will and free choice, this is the emotion that focus manifests, and it's not good. So turn around, make a U-turn. The ego provides what is referred to as negative emotion. It's out of alignment emotion because the soul cannot communicate. How would we know when we're out of alignment? We come fully equipped with all this stuff. So the ego loves us. So the ego, warning signs, warning, warning, you're out of alignment. Go back, go back. And that's that negative emotion that we feel. That's communication with the aspects of us.
Okay, fair enough. You said something a few minutes ago. You said timeline in this timeline. Mm-hmm. That is something that has been talked about, is being talked about more and more every day. Parallel realities, the multiverse, how we spin off multiple timelines in a lifetime to kind of work out, like, should I marry Cindy? Should I not marry Cindy? Should I work with Alex? Should I not work with Alex?
Don't marry Cindy.
And we kind of play those out to see what actually would happen in those scenarios. I'd love to hear your point of view on parallel realities in the multiverse.
Well, what do you think we're going to say? It's all about vibrational.
It's all about vibrational agreement. I understand. But can you explain?
Can you explain
the concept of, because it's really hard for our little brains to understand
for our current limited understanding. Yeah.
Correct. The idea of parallel realities, multiverse, and even if you want to go even deeper, that all our lives are happening at the same time. There is no past, there is no future, because that is a human construct.
Right.
I'd love to hear if you can explain it in a way that our limited minds can understand it.
Think of a ball. We would say that, of course, everything is happening now, only because, what do you think we're going to say? Because everything is vibrational and the energy is moving all the time, all the time, all the time. You're old enough. You remember the pinball machines, right? Remember a pinball machine?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you shoot the ball off and it's all cockeyed, it's bouncing off all these bumpers, but it's going really fast, bouncing off the sides and all these bumpers in the middle. That's what we refer to as a vulnerable vibration. You're creating every time you bounce on something, but you don't know where you are. Then you shoot it straight and it goes straight down in alignment. So if you think about the universe is always expanding, and there's unlimited vibrations in a universe, right? And in order to manifest, you must have vibrational agreement, and vibrational agreement happens now. It happens in every single moment. So there's no way to simply put any of that anybody would understand to the degree that it would be as simple as it really is.
That makes sense.
It doesn't make sense to you, but if you think about it from the vibrational perspective, there is only intention, right? Focus, vibrational agreement, and experience. That's our process. That's the process of creating.
So then what advice would you give someone who is having a difficult time feeling overwhelmed by the negative things that are happening in the world right now? Because there's a lot of negative things happening in the world and a lot of people who are choosing to connect with those feelings, especially the news. And the news is not helping. So what advice would you give them?
Three words, turn it off. Turn it off. You have to, in order, again, the only way to change your experience is to choose a different vibrational component from which to create. It's the only way to change your experience. And it's not changing it. That's already created. Abraham calls it, it's old news. Manifestation is old news, right? It's already done. That's the vibrational agreement. Here's the experience. Have at it. So you have to shift your perspective. You have to. And people say to us all the time, it's too hard. Can't do it. It's too hard. And we say, you don't have to do it. But this is why you're creating and creating what you're creating over and over and over and over again. And it gets more intense because the more you focus on it, the more momentum you're building from the out of alignment vibrational pattern you got going. And the path just widens. It just keeps widening. And everything that is in alignment with what you're creating, which is out of alignment, will manifest for you. Experience after experience, ultimately in your body, ultimately you get ill because you are causing your cells, which are reacting to your vibration, to be out of alignment as well. There's no ending to that. There's no good ending. You just have to shift your perspective. You have to change what you're doing now. Turn off the TV. Go to a funny movie, put old sitcoms on, whatever it is, you've got to take yourself out of the space. Nobody can do it for you.
Well, with people, and I've had this happen to me in my life, and I'd love to hear your thoughts about it. And I think most people have had at one point or another, when people around you who seemingly are extremely happy and they get ill, they get deathly ill sometimes. Leading to passing, cancers and things like that. But they're good people. They've done good things, all this kind of stuff. Obviously. No, but again, that thing that I was telling you, why do bad things happen to good people? But why would, if you're not aligned vibrationally to cancer, how did cancer enter the conversation is my question to you.
So now we're going to say, so after everything you've heard us say, you answer that.
It's frequency, it's vibration. I get that. But
the person
So the person is, whether they know it or not, in vibration with that illness.
You're here. We're all here. If you're on this earth, you have contrasting vibrations as your physical. We're still journeying through it. You know, but we're still here. We're still here. So, of course, when something triggers an old, it could be a vibration. It could have been from an experience you had 5,000 years ago. It doesn't matter. There's no time. It's in your physical vibration. And as something triggers it, somebody else gets sick, or somebody, I had a friend that was scared to death getting cancer. She was on the internet every day, going to doctors three or four times, hard, and healthy, you know, played golf all the time, just healthy, healthy. Well, guess what happened? You know, she got cancer, of course. And I kept telling her, you got to stop. I'm going to avoid it. I don't want it. Well, that's an invitation. Her focus is the invitation. This is why, you know, so back to your question, that's what, you know, people say, well, how can a baby? Well, the baby has picked up that physical vibration. That's what keeps it tethered here. We have a physical vibration that is dominant. Our bodies are a manifestation of our unique vibration, the health of us. Now, that doesn't mean she can't heal. Everybody has the ability to heal itself. Everything. Mm-hmm. You have the ability, you have to have the belief, and you have to shift.
Well, the placebo effect. It's like the placebo effect. You have to believe it.
You have to believe it. And the funny thing is that the more you start focusing on your soul's beliefs, the more you are consciously really shifting your physical vibrational makeup to be 55, 60, 70, 80, and then doors start to open. And then you cannot be in alignment consistently and be ill, because the body heals itself. The cells of your body are responding to what you are focused on. Focus is so important. You know, it's really the creation of everything.
So then let me ask you this. How are the wars and the conflicts that are happening globally affecting our collective spiritually?
Well, it's an opportunity again. You know, we see it. Those of us who watch with compassion as observers and holding a light. It's odd for me to say that because I don't, but when you hold the vibration, if you are watching something that's going down on TV or whatever, and you know, all these things have been happening all the time for the past several years. And every time you look at you go, I can't believe this. So where are you going to go then? Where are you going to go? You're here. So you can either choose to focus on how bad that is. And oh my God, I got a call. Did you see what happened? There are 43 people dead. You just start this pathway and you throw yourself back in the steaming pot again, you know, and mix it up with all those people. There is an opportunity to, so now you're looking at what's going on and now you step into your soul's perspective of compassion and love and peace, and you hold the peace. And now you can observe it as an experience of a manifestation for these people. And you have your own experience of what you're seeing. And you hold the vibration of your soul. Still human. You hold it with compassion, not fear. You hold it with love of your own understanding of manifestation.
We've been speaking a lot about vibration and frequency in this conversation. I think, right? Is there a vibrational charge or frequency charge to an eclipse, astrologically, to the planet itself? Is there a changing of the energy because of it, or the frequency because of it?
Sure, yeah, because it's the movement that changes it. It's the movement and the direction of the energy, but also what changes it for the human collective experience in all our unique ways and collectively to all simultaneously is the focus on it. So we would say to you that if everyone who was planning to watch it or watch it on TV or step outside, even if you're not in the place and feel the energies of it, if everyone who was doing that was holding a place of love, it would shift the collective. Immediately, it would shift the vibration of the collective to alignment. Now, how long you choose to hold that vibration is up to you. The whole thing is up to you. But we'll tell you that if everyone was doing that and focused on alignment while viewing this beautiful universal shift, it's part of the shift. From the position of alignment, every single human who is holding that vibration and focused on the shift of the universe would expand simultaneously.
Can you explain to people who don't understand what is happening currently for humanity, this consciousness shift that we've been talking, can you explain it to somebody who doesn't really understand what this means for humanity itself as a collective and for the individuals inside of it?
Yeah. It's exciting. It's really exciting. We describe it like this. Again, when you first dive into, let us start in a new place. There are unlimited aspects of your soul, right? We refer to God as the collective soul, which is, you know, everything. It's just everything. So you, Alex, have a unique soul. Cindy has a unique soul. Everybody has a unique soul. And you are a unique aspect of your unique soul. So you, brand new to the third dimension, right? Out of a desire of your soul to expand itself as love, says, How else can we do that? Well, let's create a new aspect that can go figure it out. And as that aspect expands in love, so will we. So the aspect dives into the third dimension and it comes in knowing nothing about who it really is, which is the manifesting and expanding of itself through its own dominant creative force, which at that time is 99% in the contrast, 1% love, because it has no idea who it is. And as it journeys through this contrasting dimension by choice, leaves, comes back thousands of times, unlimited experiences of this dimension of contrast. And as we are moving through those timelines, all in vibrational alignment with the contrast, but all different and unique, okay? But they're still dominant in the contrast, so they're here. We are moving through them. We are walking through the third dimension, out of it, right? So as we leave and come back, we are always expanding through a shift in our consciousness. Every single time we come back, we have expanded by way of our soul's expansion, the collective us. So every time we come back, we're evolving, but we're always evolving within the third dimension as this aspect. Now, there comes a time when we realize we get to this level of understanding, level of knowing, as we've expanded by way of our soul, more of who we really are. And we say, wait a minute, we're the ones that are creating this. We have the choice. We have the power of our soul. We are an aspect of our soul. Let's figure this out. What the hell are we doing? So all those timelines we're experiencing, shift in consciousness, but we didn't pay much attention because we're still in the contrast. But now, here we sit on the precipice of a new experience as the physical human of the soul, the fourth dimension. The numbers or labels you have assigned, we'll use them. It's an opportunity for a different experience as the physical aspect of you. Of course, you keep expanding. So now you sit on this precipice of the fourth dimension. And when this is a conscious shift. That's why we're conscious of it now. It must be done consciously. And when you are dominantly creating from your soul's perspective, that fourth dimension is the downhill slide. And you go from 5150 contrast soul to 5149 soul contrast. And then it's all downhill. Then you go 60-40, 70-30. This is the experience of the fourth dimension. 80-20. And when you hit the 100% mark, you're in the new earth vibration, where there's no contrast anymore. So in essence, it's a walking out of the fog. It's a walking out of the fog. And the more you evolve, the less dense you become. And that's mastery.
So essentially we are, on a rudimentary level, we're God's algorithm, in a sense.
That's good.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Well, your own, yeah, it absolutely does. That's pretty good.
I mean, as an algorithm,
we're an algorithm now. My God,
as you were explaining it, I'm like, well, I said on a rudimentary level. I said very basic level.
Yeah,
the soul is much more complicated than an algorithm. Please don't say anything in the comments.
We would say we're much more simple. Yeah,
but you know what I mean.
Yes.
In the sense. It is kind of like that in many ways.
Well, you're creating it. Yeah, you're creating it. Now we know we're creating it, right? Jane Roberts, you know, Seth, back in the 60s said, look what you guys are doing. You know, you're creating this. Look how long it took us to get it. Wow. And so now we get it. You know, we get it. People don't really understand. A lot of people still don't understand how you create your reality because it's a process. It's a process of understanding who you really are. It's an unfolding that never ends or eternal, you know? So I say the sooner you get it, the better off you are, because it's much more fun to live from the space of being dominant in your soul than it is the other way around.
So that is probably one of the big mistakes that people took away from a movie like The Secret or The Concept of the Law of Attraction, whereas they focus on the physical aspects of things to manifest right. and create their reality. But the truth is that they need to understand who they are. And the and when they understand who they truly are and that fog starts to lift, then the creation process of your own life is a vibrational thing where you are aligned with whatever vibration you are at the moment and choosing. Continuously choosing. Exactly. Choosing, that's the word. And that's how you begin to create the reality. But if you are sitting in a third dimension little place and trying to create in a fifth dimensional manifestation, it doesn't work. That's why the law of attraction and the secret didn't work for a lot of people. It did for some, but not for, and it might work in some aspects here and there, but to truly control the creation of your reality, you need to be aligned at a high level. And then when we talk about the masters are so highly high frequency that they are truly physically, even sometimes creating the reality around themselves, even to the level of a Babaji who literally, you know, is building castles out of thin air because they are such at a level that they can do things like that. Does that all make sense?
Of course, yes, because they understand vibration. They understand vibration. And you can, you know, in meditation or when somebody does a past life regression, you know, when I did a few of them and they're kind of wild, but I'll tell you, I understand that is a, it's a choosing to hop on another timeline, check out what was going on over there, you know? And when you're in alignment with your soul, now we would say that you are choosing your alignment because you are always in alignment with something. And if you are in if you're in alignment with the contrast, you're also experiencing the contrast, right? So if you take out the judgment and look at it from the in or out of alignment choosing and the experiences that manifest from those choices, you begin quickly to take control of your choosing and your focus, and you understand. And then you start to see little things happen. You know, starts to see little things. People expect too much. They don't understand that this is a complete shift of perspective that's happening now. That's what it is. It's a shift in the human perspective of contrast, where there are no, there are no sayings like life is really hard or you have to work really hard to accomplish anything, and if you don't look like this, then you're not, you know, people buy into this unworthiness kind of muckety muck, you know, and it just spreads all over the place. But that's alignment with contrast and experience of it.
Do you see any spiritual movements or awakenings happening in this year, or if not this year, in the next rest of this decade?
Imagine that you are asking if there will be a spiritual event that will wake a lot of people up at the same time. And we say that happens on a daily basis. And it has been happening since you stepped foot in the dimension you're experiencing now.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
We'll just want to add to that.
Please go ahead.
We'll just add to that. What you would refer to as a mass awakening happening now. You see it in your own success. You see it in your own creation and the ease. Although we know we're watching, but we know the effort that you are putting in, and we know the joy that you are finding also that it brings to you. And so you are feeling, you are experiencing the expansion of the collective in your unique way by the expanding of what your purpose is. And your own focus is expanding. And as you are expanding, you are experiencing the unfolding of this amazing manifestation that you are living and creating in every moment. That is your best evidence of a spiritual awakening. If you are anticipating the physical appearance of a Archangel Michael, he is there all the time. And if you are, if you will carry a belief that tells you you can see him, you will see him. You are so supported by the masters, the ones you call the masters. They are aspects of all of you. They are aspects, and they are sharing and emanating the love for your planet at this time, knowing the struggles that you are having and saying, come this way, come this way, come this way. And this way is the way that Jesus spoke about, and the way is love. The way is joy. Joy. It is joy. That is what the secret left out. It's not the material things. As soon as you attach a monetary, you can't, it's a monetary reward, you are out of alignment with your soul's desire of joy. You see, there's no vibrational agreement. There's one's in contrast and one's not.
What part does shows like mine and others around the world play in this awakening that we're going through? Because we are alternative media, shows like mine are alternative to the fear mongering and the misinformation a lot of times that you hear from the mainstream. These, and it's not, I mean, I'm one small part of this giant, you know, giant movement in regards to shows like this, podcasts, all these kind of things around the world. Can you explain to people what this means for this awakening that we're all going through?
Well, it is evidence, again, it is evidence of the focus that is being shifted. It is the evidence, because every show, whether it resonates with you or your audience, there is a purpose for everyone who's stepping forward. Everyone has a purpose. Everyone has someone seeking them. And if you look back over the evolution just in the last 100 years, the evolution of the awareness of this kind of stuff that we all talk about and we love to talk about, right? We come here so we can hear somebody talk about it because we can't talk about it out there. Well, the out there is getting much smaller. And so you will, at some point in the not so distant future, you will become a part of the mainstream. Because your mainstream is attracting its mainstream. The more people who are focusing on, and there are millions, the more people, and growing every day, but the more people who are focusing on your show and shows like yours, the more teachers are stepping forward, and you are creating what we refer to as a collective grouping of this love vibration. You are the ones who will move. You are the front runners. You are leading the pack. Esther refers to it as on the leading edge, yes. And Cindy refers to it as the machete cutting the new road ahead, because we don't know where we're going in this particular shift, which we'd like to add to our answer that we left off before, is that we have shifted consciousness many, 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 many times. This time we don't know how to live without fear, which is why we need a fourth dimension. We need a buffer zone to learn how to do it. And this is when you shift your consciousness, you don't live in, there's no fear there. So you can't experience it. And the more you know about that, the less you choose it and you walk yourself out. Anyway, so that all plays into the growth of the quick growth. Everything, trust us when we say, everything that is happening now, regardless of your perspective of it, is assisting humanity in moving forward. It is presenting choice, big choice, and you are watching people flood to you. People are flooding to the vibration. Your whole setup, your whole intention, from a vibrational perspective, is in alignment. You can see that. You're experiencing it. Everybody sees it. Everybody sees it. It is the evidence and the exampling of building an in alignment. I don't like the word business. It's not a business. It's a platform that is offering choice for people. You're offering information. And this is what this next segment of the human collective journey is a choosing, a conscious choosing. So in order to choose, there must be opportunity to choose. And you guys step up and you say, we're over here. And people flood you.
Do you? I had this thought the other day, and I'd love to hear your thoughts about it, that one day in the distant future, maybe not so distant, our ancestors or our, not ancestors, would be the predecessor. What's the opposite of ancestor? The forward the versions kids. Of ourselves. Yeah, the generations
people
ahead
behind
of
us. Oh, ahead
no,
of
the
us.
People in front of us. Yeah, all the generations in front of us, you know, four or five generations ahead of us will look back on a show like this and find it quaint and find it, oh, wow, they needed this. This is all fundamental.
Now we'll stop you there, and we will say that we will say that they will look at it with love, mm-hmm. and joy, because there is no judgment from where we're heading. There is mm-hmm. no judgment. There is understanding, and there is love and joy and excitement, knowing that this platform that you are creating, and it's going to be huge, first of all, but this whole thing around the world, it's like, God, is that even possible? You know, they have the circle of people around the world, and they're all holding hands, and they're in the water, and they're all over, they're walking on the water, and they're just around. This is what I'm seeing. This is a big, it's a big connection. So it's a worldwide connection. And I totally derailed.
Around, around the that it would be people from other generations will come back and look at this as quaint.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. So it will, and it, oh yeah, no, it, yeah, worldwide. It will. I'm gonna. It's kind of Bible-ish, in that mm-hmm. it will last that long. It is a teaching tool, because if we're all the teachers, everybody listening now, we're all cutting edge, right? We're all moving forward. We're paying attention, and we're all expanding. Well, if we're the first set at this level, not the first set, but we're in the group, right? We're the newcomers coming in, and we're all teaching something different. But there's always going to be somebody at this level of understanding.
Mm.
So you provide that first level, and then you'll expand, and you expand. You continue to expand your knowing. You continue to expand your own knowing, which expands your manifestation, which expands your teaching, your whatever you're doing there. Big.
This is the ABCs of spirituality, of movement, of higher consciousness. And you're saying that there'll always be, if you're here in the third dimension, there will always be someone just getting here, just starting this process. Yeah. Well, and it happens now every day. Things that we've spoken about in this conversation are very fundamental, and it's almost like don't even think about it.
Yeah.
But there might be 20 things that we said in this conversation that will make someone's head explode. Because they would just never heard it before, and they've been waiting for it. So
it'll resonate. Yes.
Yeah, and it'll resonate with them in a way that it doesn't resonate for us anymore, because you and I have already gone through this level. You know, it's kind of like, oh yeah, we understand frequency, we understand vibration.
Good.
Oh no, don't get me wrong, it still feels fantastic. No, but and I'm not saying that as a better or worse thing, because I'm just saying it on a different scale of we're all learning. There's things that I might know that you don't, and things that you don't, that you are, you know, that I don't.
Everyone's
learning at different levels about everything. So I like that. I never really thought about that. I guess I was a little too Pollyannic that five or six generations from now, everyone's evolved. There's no anything. Everything's fantastic.
No, because you're always going to be looking ahead. Mm-hmm. You'll always be looking ahead, you know, why we're saying, look ahead. Don't look back. There's no looking back. Can't unexperience something, and you can't unlearn something. Everything that we've experienced and learned and understood and created from has gotten us here. Mm-hmm. You know, we know we can create new stuff. You don't change the old stuff. You create new stuff.
Cindy, do you have any parting messages for the audience, less things that you really want the audience to take home with them after this conversation?
Yes. Self-love. And, you know, people, I was one of them. Joseph was in the beginning, love yourself. I just blew it off. I said, I don't even know what that means. I don't even know. How can you expect me to experience something? I used to yell at them. How do you expect me to experience something when I have no idea what that means? I don't know how that feels. And they said, how do you think it feels? And that started a new journey. But self-love is so important because we have all these contrasting vibrations in us. You know, the unworthiness is probably the biggest one that most people have in some form or another from this lifetime or another. It doesn't matter. And, you know, finding out and discovering who you really are, and, you know, that's like alignment is self-love. When you're in alignment, you feel the love of your soul, you know, which everybody wins from that, you know, because when you're focused there, you're creating from there and you're creating love. You're creating space for people to love, you know, to experience love. It's the most important thing. You know, it's a creative force, powerful. So I say focus, focus, focus on that.
Cindy, where can people find out more about you and the amazing work that you and Josef are doing to awaken the planet?
Everything's on our website, teachingsofjosef.com. You can get to our YouTube from there. The books are there. Join us on Instagram there. We post quotes every day there. Yeah, one-stop shopping. No shopping. one-stop info. One-stop. We love
Cindy,
it. We love it.
Cindy, it's been such a pleasure and honor talking to you again. Thank you and Josef for everything that you're doing to awaken the planet. And I truly, truly appreciate you. So thank you again.
Ditto, man. Thank you. We appreciate you too. Thanks for all you're doing.
Thanks for watching. Click on one of the videos below to continue your journey. And don't forget to subscribe.